Do you work at a SaaS startup, or maybe you're thinking about starting one on your own? Then you must know that tracking the right metrics can make or break your company. In this video, we'll discuss 5 KPIs your startup should absolutely track to ensure success. Make sure to watch till the end, as we're gonna talk about how to identify the right KPIs for your SaaS business and how to avoid some of the most common mistakes and pitfalls. Hi, this is Minty Analyst, I'm Dobry, and let's get straight to it. There's no question that data is extremely important for startups, but which data points should you track? How do you identify which are the right ones that would help your business succeed? KPIs are crucial for startups because they can help you track your progress, identify areas for improvement, and make decisions where to focus your already limited resource. When you're identifying the right KPIs for your business, there are 3 things you should consider. Number 1, make sure your KPIs are completely aligned with your overall business goals. 2, choose KPIs and metrics that you can actually measure and track over time. And last but not least, remember to not get too hung up on the numbers. KPIs are just one tool to help you track your progress. Nowadays, we have an abundance of data, which means that there are tons of metrics or KPIs that we can track. Here are 5 that most founders agree are critical. Number 1, monthly recurring revenue, or MRR. This is the lifeblood of any SaaS business, and it's a key indicator of growth and success. MRR includes your sales revenue from users that have an active subscription, meaning that when you're calculating it, you should exclude all one-off revenues like setup fees or one-off purchase of an additional service. You should really track and care about your monthly recurring revenue, because a healthy MRR growth rate is usually a sign that your startup is doing well in growing its user base and expanding its reach. Number 2 is the customer churn rate. This is the percentage of customers that cancel their subscription each month. It is important to analyze your churn rate and figure out how to keep it low so that you're not losing too many customers. For example, if your SaaS solution has 100 subscribers that pay you a monthly subscription fee and you have a churn rate of 5%, this means that every month you're losing 5 of those customers, which in turn means that every month, first, you have to find 5 new customers in order to keep your revenue flat. And if you want to grow and scale, you have to find additional customers on top of that. That's why it's really important to analyze your churn rate and figure out how to keep it low. Number 3 is the customer lifetime value, or CLV. This is the average amount of money that a customer spends with your business over the course of their subscription lifetime. There are different ways to calculate CLV. For example, some people take their full revenue from a customer and consider that their customer lifetime value, while others prefer a more conservative approach and deduct the cost of goods sold or cost of providing the service from the revenue for a specific customer. It is essential to track your CLV because it helps you figure out how much you can spend to acquire a customer while still remaining profitable over their lifetime. Number 4 is CAC, or customer acquisition cost. It represents the amount that you spend to acquire one new customer. And it's a really important metric in connection with CLV that we just discussed. It's really important to keep your CAC lower than your CLV if you want your business to be profitable. Initially, some startups spend more on acquiring a customer than the actual revenue that this customer is expected to bring in. And this is a strategy to quickly scale their user base and their reach. But keep in mind, if you spend too much cash to acquire too little revenue in the long term, your business is destined to fail. Number 5 is the Net Promoter Score, or NPS. This is a measure of customer satisfaction and loyalty, and it's a key indicator for customer retention. Here's how it works. You would ask your customers to rate a product, a service, or a specific step of a process on a 0 to 10 scale. The 9s and 10s are your promoters, the 0s through 6s are your detractors, and the 7s and 8s are what we call passive, and they don't play in the calculation. So once you have your 0s through 6s, your detractors, and your 9s and 10s, your promoters, you subtract the percentage of your detractors from the percentage of your promoters, and that's how you get your net promoter score. You can use NPS to track customer satisfaction over time or to compare different customer segments or cohorts. You can also ask users to rate specific steps from their customer journey and analyze those results to see where your startup is struggling and where you need to focus more energy to improve customer satisfaction and retention. As a startup founder or an early employee, you're constantly looking for ways to streamline and improve your processes and performance. By tracking these KPIs, you can get a better understanding of your business's performance and identify areas where you need to make changes and improve. For example, if you see that your churn rate is increasing, this means that something is wrong with your customer retention and you need to focus more resources on retaining customers for longer. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, there are a few common mistakes that a lot of startups make when it comes to tracking and identifying their KPIs. The biggest one is getting lost in all the data you can track and visualize on a dashboard and not actually tracking the right KPIs for your business from the start. As a SaaS startup, you should focus on metrics that are aligned with your business goals and can help your decision-making process. Another big mistake is not tracking and analyzing KPIs regularly. You must establish a regular cadence for calculating and reviewing KPIs so that you can course correct as needed and in a timely manner. And the final and most detrimental mistake is not actually taking action based on what your KPIs are telling you. And a lot of times, especially if you're a founder, you're often really into the idea and it's hard to take a step back and look at what the numbers are telling you. And as a SaaS business, it's essential for you to track KPIs and use them to support your decision making and figure out where your limited resources would yield the most benefit. Okay, but how exactly do you pick the right KPIs to track? Now, this will really depend on your business specifics and what is important to you. However, there are a few things you can keep in mind to ensure that you're tracking the right metrics for your business. First, think about what you want to achieve with your SaaS startup. What are your goals? What would success look like? Once you have a good idea of what you're trying to achieve, you can start to think about the KPIs that would help you measure this success. It is also important to take a look at who you're trying to reach with your product or service. What are their needs and wants? What would make them pick your product or service over your competitors? Answering those questions will help you figure out KPIs that are important for your target audience. Finally, don't forget to think about KPIs that are important for your team and your business as a whole. This may include employee satisfaction, employee churn rate, or various financial metrics. I have left a link in the description below to a free benchmark analysis template in Excel where you can take a look at various financial metrics you may track as KPIs. When it comes to actually tracking the metrics, be careful not to get bogged down into too much detail when setting up your KPI framework. There's no question that specialized software can help you track and measure your KPIs more effectively. But ask yourself, is this really necessary? Can't you just use Excel while you're still scaling and fine-tuning and figuring things out? The answer really depends on the size and complexity of your business. If you're just starting out or if you're a simple or small operation, then Excel is perfectly fine. You don't need to spend time implementing complex solutions only to end up using just a few features. But if you're a larger or more complex business, then dedicated software can certainly help you track and measure your KPIs. Dedicated solutions can help you track metrics in real time, set up alerts and notifications, and generate reports. Just make sure you don't spend too much time and effort setting up sophisticated KPI tracking solutions early on, because the resources this would require might be better spent elsewhere. By the way, if you're working in a startup or thinking about starting your own, you probably have to raise money at some point. Here's a video outlining the most critical slides that you must have in your pitch deck in order to succeed. Thank you for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you're not already, and maybe even punch the bell icon to receive notifications every time I upload a new video. Till then, Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.